So you have seen my flash drive.
Okay. Listen, I am going upstairs really quick. Okay, I just need to grab something. Do not touch my computer.
Okay.
Did you hear me? Do not touch my computer.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, yes, ma'am. That's what I want to hear. I'll be right. Okay.
It's just so boring here. Just need to check one thing. YouTube. Loading. Oh no, why? Why my fingerprints off so she doesn't know it was me?
Not find it. What are you doing on the floor?
Just praying. For a good day?
For a good day? Really, on the couch. Why can't you sit on a couch and pray if you want to pray? You have got to be kidding me, little girl. You know what? Come here, you little girl. You know what? How dare you touch my computer?
Hey, you've got to be kidding me right now.
What is the problem?
Mm-hmm. Leah, what is the problem?
Mm-hmm. What's the
problem? I didn't do anything. She's mad at me for nothing. Oh.
So you didn't touch my computer?
Oh, I didn't see that computer before.
Michelle, why are you being mean?
You have got to be
kidding
me. Leah,
go ahead and wait on in front, okay? I'm going to take you off with some ice cream. Why are you being mean to the child?
Oh, that little girl sometimes, I swear.
I know she's something else, right?
Oh, my God.
But look, I came over here to say thank you so, so much for giving me this job. You don't know how much I love working with you, Jay, and my in-law, Robert.
Oh, God, girl, stop it. I do see, however, your love life is picking up.
Yes, it is.
So, Dwayne is serious about moving here, huh?
Yes, it's official, girl. I just put the down payment on the apartment, and I'm going to go buy all the furniture. I can't wait. I'm so, so, so excited, and I know you have reservations, but...
No, look. Come on. Listen, you're my cousin, girl. I love you. It's just, I'm just, you know, really cautious when it comes down to long-distance relationships.
I know. I just want what you and Robert have, that strong love. I crave it.
Now listen, wait a minute now. We have our shares of ups and downs, okay? You just, at the end of the day, you just gotta know if he's worth it.
I know.
In fact, he asked me to stay late at work tonight.
Mm-hmm, why?
I don't know, he said he has something to tell me.
What do you think he has to tell you?
I don't know.
Girl, after 2 years, you're going to get married.
Stop!
Yes!
Stop!
He's going to propose.
No, you really think so? Don't
yes,
do that.
Yes, if someone told me they seen him at the mall, looking at princess cuts.
Seriously?
That's just what someone told me.
No, please, Brittany, come on. Don't get my hopes
up. Girl, you're going to be the prettiest bride. I can't. Am I going to be the maid of honor?
Of course. Am I going to
be? I cannot wait.
Oh, my God. I cannot believe it. Oh, my God.
Yes.
I promise. It
girl,
won't be
you going to get a date in a ring.
I'll be there.
I'm so excited. You're
going to
be so pretty.
Yeah.
Hey!
Hi, Brittany.
How's it going?
Fine. How are you?
Good.
What are you
girl,
doing?
It's a box. It's a box.
Go. Don't you.
Dun, 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 dun.
Oh, my God.
Dun, dun,
oh, my God.
Dun, 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 dun,
oh, my God.
What are you two up to?
I don't know. You know, Brittany, listen, I'll be right with you. I know you said to stay late from work tonight. I'm almost done. I promise.
Listen, don't worry about it. Don't rush
it.
You know, I just really came down here just to talk to you about something. A little bit important. Let's see. Michelle?
Yes?
You know I love you, right?
Of course I do.
Yeah. So listen, last night, I was up pretty late just thinking about my life and the things I've accomplished, the people I've encountered, and all I can think about was you. You know, how I've been so trapped in Michelle's world, underwater without an opportunity to breathe. But what's funny is I never wanted to. You know, in the last year and a half we've been staying together, it's been cool.
Cool? It's been more than cool. Don't play with me.
Aight. It's been aight.
Uh-huh.
Listen, come here. Come here. Have a seat. Do you remember me telling you how my first love was acting?
Yeah.
All right, so let's just say that my love for you has surpassed that, and it's made me forget all about it. I mean, it's almost a gift and a curse, really.
Wait, what are you talking about?
I don't know, after last night, like, everything it just kind of makes sense to me. The reason I can't pursue my first love is, well, it's because my second love is taking over.
Oh, come on, Robert, what are you talking about?
Michelle, listen, I have to pursue my dream as an actor, and I can't because...
Hey, why not?
Because you become my distraction.
No, what? Baby, come on, if it's me working along hours, baby, I swear to you, I can change.
I mean, it's not even that, it's just...
Let's
not forget about Leah staying with us. Now, listen, I like Leah.
Okay.
And I commend you for stepping up in your sister's place when she talked about putting her in a foster home. But I mean, damn, Michelle, did you even think about having a child of our own to care for first? But that's cool because I supported you. Which is why I'm asking you to support the decision that I'm about to make right now.
Come on, baby. What decision are you talking about?
I'm moving to LA. And I'm leaving at the end of the week. Listen, I'm sorry, but it's just something I just gotta do, alone.
Ooh. Okay. So, let me get this straight. Oh, God. So, you're leaving, and you're excited about your future? LA, right? Yeah. That's the hub where all the actors go to make it big, right? Right? That's where they go. And I know you're going to have tons of auditions to go on to, right? I know you are, baby. Because that's what you do. You set goals and you make it. And I know you want to hit that next major film or you want to be a part of that next major role, right? Now, while all the while you're in California auditioning, I'll be here auditioning men who I don't even know, who I don't even trust, just to fill your role.
Come on, Michelle. I mean, why do you gotta take things out of proportion? Me going back home to Cali gives me an opportunity to make up for missed time with my friends and my family.
So first it was, I want to go ahead and pursue my career. Then it was Leah. Now you miss home? Oh my God, this cannot be happening right now. This is not happening. Okay, come. Get your thoughts. Wait, baby, wait. Okay, no, look, I got it. I got the perfect plan. Okay? I got the perfect idea, I swear to you. I can see it right now. Okay. Yeah. I'll pack all my things and I'll get on the next thing smoking with you, baby. And when it comes to Leah, I'll just give her back to my mom, okay? My mom loves her. We'll watch her. She won't even mind, I swear to you. And when it comes down to your auditions, baby, I'll be right there with you. I'll help you study your lines. And your family, we'll be right there with your family together. We can do it together. I promise you, baby, it's perfect. It's beautiful. I can see it being in California, the weather, together, baby. Oh, my God. If that's the only reason, right? Oh, damn, Robert, you ain't have to do me like that.
You know, I didn't. I came down here trying to spare your feelings. But now you want the truth, I give you the truth. I reconnected with Sharon.
Sharon, seriously?
We got together for lunch about a week ago, got to talking about the past. I don't even know why I explained to myself. I told you about this woman.
No, you know what you told me? You told me how you hated her and how I was different.
Maybe I was wrong.
You know what? I get it. So, let me get this straight. If she's the love of your life, then what am I?
A rebound.
What?
Definitely wasn't expecting that one.
What's up, Robert?
You?
You wanted to talk to us?
What's up, fellas?
Not much, man. What's going on?
Man, you all right?
Yeah.
Boy, man. Like he lost his little shit to or something.
Let's just say, I hope y'all take the news better than Michelle just did.
Hey, whoa. Take what better than Michelle did?
Well, Jay, I think I'm moving out to L.A., man.
What?
What?
Oh, Jay, I told you, man. I told you this dude was a fraud, man. Look at him.
Come on, Terrell. Why I gotta be all that?
Wow, man. I love him like you and you know it, man. The only reason I tolerate you because Jay is my boy.
Hold on. What did Michelle say about this move?
A smack to the face. Said she wasn't too happy about it.
That's good for him, man. How she smack you? She smack you like this or she smack you like this?
Man, you gotta get this dude, Jay.
Robert, why are you doing this, Robert? We was on the cusp of doing something great and now you just gonna leave us?
Man, I gotta take advantage of this opportunity, Jay. Come on, if you know me best, you know I've always wanted to act.
And I always wanted to go to the moon, but you don't see me buying no damn spacesuit now, do you?
Man, would you shut up? Jay, come on, man. You seen me on the films. You know I got what it takes.
You're right. You are a very, very good actor.
Thank you.
Because you've been acting like a homeboy this entire time when you know you wasn't.
You know, I never thought I'd hear those words come out your mouth, man. We've known each other for so long.
I never thought you would be telling your friend that you just dropping us at the dime to move to L.A.
Man, at the very least, I thought you'd congratulate me.
What the? You're right, man. Where's my manners? Congratulations, bro.
Thank you.
Get the hell out of our spot.
It's like that? All right. It's cool.
Hey, Robert.
What?
You say you broke up with Michelle, right?
Why?
I just want to know if she need a little rebound. That's all. I might bounce up into life. You feel me?
Terrell, really? That's what you thinking about right now? You thinking about Michelle?
Man, hell no, man.
I'm so pissed right now, man. How could he do this? We was on the cusp of doing something great, and now he just stops at the middle of a dime right when we about to blow up and just leave?
So what now, Jay?
Man, I don't know. I don't know. Because after he take his money out, man, we going to be strapped for cash.
I can't take out no loan, man.
Why not?
Well, my credit's go low as hell. You tripping.
Well, we got to figure out something, man. Because if we don't, we're going to be closing our business down early as next week. Good God almighty, man. Hey, Michelle.
How? Oh, hi, Michelle.
Whatever. Don't talk to me right now. I'm not in the mood.
Yeah, she never in the mood.
Clothes are missing, but his key's still here.
prepared my whole life for this moment. Telling me it's too late. And I finally got it. Please don't ask me why. A broken heart. Damn, that shit hurts. But I can't stop and walk. I thought by now I'd be showing off my ring. Planning my wedding. What changed so quickly? Having my first father-daughter dance. Yeah, that's how far we women go when we think it's all right. Now I'm one phone call away from calling my brothers to bait both of his legs so he don't make it out to Cali. Now that's how far we go when we know it's wrong. And now the next man gotta pay for what Robert did. And which Michelle would he even get? Waking the one who's insecure. Because every time you tell me you miss me or love me, how can I not be insecure when the love of my life, he just walked out? Leaving through the door.
No. Mm-mm. Maybe he'll get the wow, Michelle. Yeah. The one who just wants to have fun. No commitments. She just wants to live life. And should I tell him I'm just using him for fun? All is fair in love and war, right? Should I tell him he's my rebound? Hell no. Robert ain't telling me that. Mm-mm.
Fun. Let's go. Let's ride. Let's show them how we do it in the 305.
Oh. Baby, you know how we always having fun. We always partying. Party, we always taking shots, turning up. You know, doing what we do. Yeah, this is Michelle.
Oh.
She's total opposite of that.
Okay. I'm sorry. Look, I'm not always like this.
Ah, you know what? We don't need all that. Listen. I don't need you to hold a hand too long. That's okay. Too much negativity rubbing up on you,
God,
baby.
He's such a jerk. How are you even with him?
Because he's himself. He knows how to make me laugh. He knows how to have fun. And he knows how to make love.
Ooh,
my
Mr.
little
lover.
Champion lover.
Mr. Lover, lover.
Hey.
Ooh. Mr. Lover, lover.
Really? He's so silly. Really? Really?
You think it's silly. I think it's wonderful.
Yeah, all right. Ooh.
I gotta take this call. Mm-hmm. What they do, boy?
So, you're not even gonna ask him who's calling him?
Oh, girl, please. I am not worried about that. And he's here with me, okay? My sexy, dark chocolate, tall man, intelligent man.
Intelligent? Girl, we must be talking about two different people.
Look. He has these theories on relationships that are just so on point.
Like what?
Okay. You know how us women, we love to broadcast to the world that we're in a new relationship, and we're so excited to say, oh my God, I'm gonna marry this man, we're gonna have children, we've been so happy for the past 3 years, but in reality, you only see him like 3 times a week. So if you count that all together, it's only like 6 months.
Oh, okay, so let me get this straight. You two are serious then, huh?
Well, let's see. I probably see him like once a week or so. So if you add that in real time, it's only been like 2 months or some change. We don't really talk about it.
Yeah.
Yeah. But look, you gotta understand. See, men are like track meet, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Some are meant for the long distance run, and others are meant for the short distance run.
Right.
And then you pass that baton to the next man.
Mm-hmm.
Baby, we gotta get up out of here. Need to go to Chef Creole.
Oh, I get some conch for this.
You already know.
Gotta get in there.
Bye, Michelle.
You know what that conch do too, now you know.
Damn.
She ain't even ask him who that was calling him. I would have never thought she had something on me. Excuse me.
So my mom is so excited you're coming with me this weekend. That's all she keeps talking about. She's pretty much driving me crazy. She's got the caterer booked and everything's on schedule, so you can't be late like usual. You just throw us off.
What are you talking about?
This weekend with my mom.
This weekend?
Yes. Listen, pay attention. Now, I know they say you could get a lot of miles out of a Honda, but you don't have to prove it. We'll just take my Benz.
Why we can't take my Honda?
What's wrong with my car?
What's wrong with my Honda?
What is wrong with the car, Jay? What is your problem now?
What I told you about making decisions for me.
What?
Listen, I was grown when you met me, and I was doing just fine.
What that got to do with the car, Jay?
Everything has to do with the car, because you come and try to change things, and I was just doing just fine. Let's just take the Honda, roll down the windows, and we'll be good.
Jay, you need to chill out, okay? And God knows who had this vehicle before you.
I had the vehicle.
Oh, my gosh.
My brother and my dad gave it, so I don't know. We'll figure something out, but just don't make decisions.
Yeah, just calm down, okay? It's just a weekend. Plus, my family never saw this car anyway. So,
my car, your car,
Jay.
My car, honey, please.
Toronto,
baby.
Oh, hey, Alicia. Hey. I know you're going to grandma cookout this weekend.
It's this weekend?
Yeah, man, I told you that.
Yes, I'm going. Oh, she got the ribs?
Hey, you already know we got the ribs. We got 8 slabs of ribs, macaroni and cheese, pizza peas and rice, baked beans, with the chopped up Garcia sausages in there. Ooh, collard greens.
Collard greens?
Man, look, we going down. You know it ain't Thanksgiving, but we got that sweet potato pie on
deck. Sweet potato pie! Hey, I'm going to have that itis.
Jay.
Let him know.
Oh, what happened?
I can't go.
What?
I promise I'll go. I promise I will go with Alicia to meet her family.
That's right. And we've got the caterer booked, so it's already scheduled, and it's set. So catered. We can't change anything. That's
catered,
right.
Huh?
That's right. That's what I said.
You know what, Jay, man? Caterer's right. Because they damn sure can't cook over there.
What?
They can't cook, Jay. I already know what they're gonna have.
What?
Wine. A little bit of cheese. Caviar. Brussels sprouts. Glazed asparagus. No butter. Not a pinch of damn salt. Bland chicken. You know that box Kraft macaroni and cheese with the squeezed cheese on it? Not to mention the rice, Jay. And where are they gonna get the potato salad from, Jay?
I don't know.
You know they can't make potato salad, Jay. Where are they gonna get it from? What, Costco's? BJ's?
That's
Publix?
Enough. Stop. That's enough. I'll be in the car.
Be in the car.
Too bad we can't have ribs this weekend.
Damn, Jay. Hey, you know what? I should have told her to give me a plate.
Why?
So I could feed my damn dog, man. Come on, man. I don't even know why you rear her, man. She's nothing like Joy.
I just don't
get it. She's boring.
Terrell, she's different.
Yeah, you're right, she's different. If you did what I told you to do from the beginning, you wouldn't be going through this problem.
What do you mean? If I would have did what you told me to do from the beginning, I wouldn't be going through this problem.
Look, man, I told you, every third time she asks you something, say no.
Say no.
Yeah.
For example.
Oh, man, look, every time you tell her no, she acts like it's her first time hearing, right?
Yeah.
And she pouts like a baby, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so just say no, and she'll get used to it.
Okay, example.
Okay, man, look, for example. After this one, I need you to follow on with me,
okay? I'm going to try
all right,
to catch
look.
On.
Okay. Baby, please, could you just pass me the salt over the table? No!
No, for some salt on the
for
table?
For some salt, you got to toughen up, man. Anything.
Okay, no.
Okay, now I need you to join along with me this one.
Okay.
Okay, it's about 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning. You
2
know?
O'clock, yeah. 3 o'clock in the morning. Okay.
Oh, my God, baby, could you please come get me? I'm stranded in the middle of the glaze. Oh, my God, I don't know what to do. Please, my tire is flat. No! What you doing, man? You're supposed to say no.
No.
No, man.
No.
There you go. Okay. I got one more. Now you need to join in, man.
All right.
Well, you know, babe, my dad doesn't get to see you a lot, and he just wants you guys to have a guide trip, a fishing trip. Could you do that, please, for me?
No.
There you go, baby. That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Baby, I'm butt naked. I want you to make love to me.
Boy, you better not say no. You better raise your hand. Say yes. Start taking the clothes off and go straight to the room.
baby. Do you remember how we met? Do you remember what today is, actually?
It's a special day.
So you really don't remember what today is?
I don't know. Why don't you remind me?
Well, today makes the first day that we met.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Hell yeah, that's right.
Do you remember how?
I know we was drunk.
Well, we were at Wet Willie's.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
You was looking at me, and I sent you a drink.
I ain't send you no drink?
No. I actually sent you two drinks.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I had two drinks. Yeah, I had two. I ain't send you no drink. Nah, yeah.
But, babe, who would have thought a year after just Skyping and seeing one another once a month and texting that we will finally be here?
That's right.
Like, babe, I just put the down payment on the apartment.
Oh, you the real one for that.
I'm going to go ahead and buy all the furniture.
Ottomans.
Yes. And you're going to go ahead and meet my mom, right? And then we're going to get married, and we're going to have, like, 10 kids, right?
Oh, hold on. Chill, baby. Yo, I just stepped off the plane. You know what I'm saying? I still got jet lag, baby.
Whatever. Well, this is where I work.
Okay.
Don't you
love it? I see you doing your thing and all that. You must be making a little money then, huh?
All right.
Like this, I'm not really into the whole office setting, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, because you're in the field.
Nah. I'm not into the whole working thing, you know what I'm saying? That's all right.
That's fine, because I bought you some outfits.
Did it match?
No, buddy, I got you applications.
Yo!
I got you like 10 applications, actually.
What you talking about, yo? Listen, I already told you. I came down here for the fun and the sun.
Okay.
It's Miami, baby. You know what I'm saying? The sunshine.
Mm-hmm.
And in case you forgot, already got my agenda planned, baby.
Remind me, please.
Oh, I will. Live on Sunday.
Got it.
All right? KOD Monday. Tuesday, we at Climax. Hey, it's Tuition Tuesdays. These babies need an education too now.
Really?
Wednesday, we at Dream. Thursday, Hip Hop Nights at Story. Friday's Iguanas. Then Saturday, babe. Yo, Saturday, I'll go to the office.
Okay, thank you, baby. At least one day you'll be at the office working. Thank you!
Yo. I'm talking about the Gentleman's Club. Next to Tootsie's on 183rd.
Well, you do realize you need money for all these places, right?
And that's where you come in, baby.
Oh, my God.
Say it ain't so. Nah, I heard it to the grapevine that you was flying some chunk down. But you know what I said? I said, my baby wouldn't do that to me.
Baby, skinny cool.
Yeah, baby, listen. You ain't got to front in the presence of this here chunk.
Hey, I ain't finna be too many more chumps, my man.
What you say, chump?
Yo, who says that word nowadays anyway?
The coolest cat on the planet, chump.
Oh, my God. Look, skinny cool, I am not in the mood today, please.
What's wrong? Did he do something to you?
Hey, bruh, yo, can me and my bravey get some privacy, please? I just touched down off the plane, you know what I'm saying? Me and my lady.
You say privacy, huh?
Yeah.
Well, you know I was in the back doing some maintenance work, putting up sheetrocks and metals and things. And I overheard your conversation. So you just got here, right? But you ain't paid for nam bit of your airplane ticket.
No.
You ain't got no job. She just gave you 10 applications that you refused to fill out. Let me see what else I heard. Oh, yeah. And she just bought your drinks when you first met.
It was two
drinks.
What?
I hope it was two for one at least.
It wasn't.
Look here, man. Until you can square up at least three of them four, you can't ask for no privacy. Nah, you can't. John.
Skinny cool, look.
What's up, baby?
I know he broke, But I love him. So please, can you just leave us alone? I want this to work, please, for me.
You know what, just for you, baby, I'll let you deal with this. But call me. Satisfaction guaranteed. Call me when your bank account is on E.
Now look, I know you just got off the plane, so I'm gonna take you home, and in the morning we're gonna wake up so I can drop you off to all these places so you can fill out all these applications. Okay?
Yo, I told you already, okay? We went over this time and time again since I got off the plane. You wanna know what I'm doing tomorrow? Just guess, guess.
What?
Not a damn thing, okay? I told you I'm trying to enjoy sunshine and I am Miami. Now listen, I know you footing the bill and all that right now. You
yes,
handling
I
things.
Am.
You a girl, you on your, you know what I'm saying? You mm-hmm. doing your thing.
Yes.
I ain't come down here empty handed. I got a couple dollars.
Well,
you
let
know
me see.
There you go.
What's this?
A couple dollars.
Oh my God.
Yo, Brittany. Brittany, come over here. Girl, come over here.
You just handed me a $2 bill.
Babe, come on. Babe, come on. Yo, chill out.
Oh, my God.
Yo, chill. I got you, right?
Okay.
I'm the real one, y'all.
This is not what we planned.
Yo, I do what I say I'm going to do, all right? Let's just not worry about working. Let's clear our minds out for a little bit.
Okay.
Let's not worry about working for, you know, a couple days.
Okay, you just got here so we can look for a job later.
Couple weeks?
Oh, God. That's fine.
Months?
Jesus.
Years.
Jesus.
Oh, whoa, whoa, babe, hold on now,
Years?
Hold on, babe, I got you. All right, yo, let me stop playing, all right? Let me get on this, yo, it's me, it's D. Yo, it's D, all right?
This is not what we planned.
Baby, it's D, all right? I told you before you got down here, I'll take care of business, you know what I'm saying? Yo, run me them car keys, yo.
For what? So you could run my gas and go up and down Biscayne?
Did I study? Yo, let me get them car keys. Yo, I'm about to make moves, yo. Do what I said I'm going to do. All right?
So what are you going
to do? Yo, don't worry about all that. I'm making the moves. I got this, all right? You got a real one. I'm about to go out to the car.
Okay.
I'm about to go ahead and crank that thing up. You know what I'm saying? Get my seat back.
You going
to
be working.
I get my rear view right. Make sure the folk ain't watching me or nothing and all that. Your AC cold blowing. I'm going to go in the car and take a nap, yo.
What?
Yo, any of your friends smoke weed? Is that a yes or a no, yo?
This is crazy. What did I just get myself into, Jesus?
Hey, Brittany.
Brit.
Don't speak to me right now. I'm not.
Why she got on that black?
Well, that's why I ain't in a relationship, man. I ain't got time for that drama, yo.
Hold on. You don't know why you in a relationship, man.
Man, forget all that. Look, I started a business with a childhood friend of mine.
You did?
Yeah, I did. And now we got to close. Come on, man. Yo, we should whoop Robert, yo. Matter of fact, you should want to whoop Robert because you brought him in here.
Hold on, Terrell. I may have an idea. You remember Joy?
Joy?
Yeah, Joy.
Joy,
my high school sweetheart.
High school sweetheart, Joy.
Yeah, high school sweetheart, Joy.
Okay.
I ran into her the other day, and she actually has an MBA. So I was talking to her, and she's moving back down here, and she was looking for something to invest in. And I was like, man, that's a coincidence, because one of our great friends just took his investments out. So we were just running back and forth ideas. And I said, man, all I got to do is run by Terrell and see what he likes. He said, well,
wait,
just set it up, and then I'll meet with him, and then we'll be
cool. Wait, hold on. What?
What? Huh?
That can get messy, man.
It's not going to get messy, Terrell, because it's all business.
Yeah, Jay, but you can't mix business with pleasure.
We're not going to mix business with pleasure. Besides, she got an MBA.
Okay. Hold up. Okay, Jay. How she look?
Ugly.
What you mean ugly? She gained weight?
Yeah, she's big like Precious.
Big like, damn, she missing teeth?
Yeah, she missing 4 to the bottom and 2 wisdom teeth.
She got bad acne?
Man, she take Proactive by the gallon, man.
So how she wearing her hair, Jay?
She got that lace front Dominican press.
No.
Microwave weave. I don't know. It's
damn,
bad.
Damn, well, she done went crazy?
No, she didn't go crazy now. She has an MBA.
Oh, Okay, look, man, I'm glad you don't got to deal with that no more. Whatever happened to you two anyway?
Well, you know, that was my little lady back in high school. And I really saw her being the one that I wanted to marry. But not at 22 years old. So I told her we should separate so I can grow up a little bit more, and then we link back up if we ever matured.
Yeah, I would have kept cheating.
No, not me. Not on Joy. I didn't want to risk losing her forever.
Huh?
Yeah.
You're a good dude, man. No, seriously, we need more guys like you around,
hey,
man.
Terrell, don't start this.
No, seriously, look. If I had a daughter, man, I'd let you marry her, man.
Shut up, man. For real. Hey, she actually asked me what I've been doing for the last couple of years while we was apart.
Mm-hmm.
You know I couldn't tell her what we've been doing for the last couple of years we was apart, Terrell.
You better not.
I'm not going to tell her.
You can't tell her about Trinidad.
Oh, no, you can't tell her about Trinidad.
2013?
Oh, yes, sir.
Boy, ain't no had that much soak in my blood, but I would get down for like 24 hours straight.
Hey, what about Cancun 2010?
Woo!
Man, they named the street after us, Terrell. We were so loose, man.
Hold up. Brazil?
Brazil?
Okay, tell about Brazil.
No, we're not going to tell them about Brazil.
We should have did time for what we did in Brazil.
Time,
boy. I'm talking about slaughter, boy. I had three over here. You had two over there. I had one over here. Mirror on the ceiling. Boy, I was in there going ham, boy. I'm going head first, boy. You was over there going head first.
Hey, I say, James,
I got to come save you. Come on now.
Terrell.
What?
Listen, I'm trying to forget times like that because I want to
be. Not me. For 5 days straight, maybe that was calling me Terrell. Papi chewing up, Papi sit down. Hey, mommy,
matter,
I see you.
Matter of fact, you was one, and I was dummy.
Okay,
we get it. Clowns and circuses, we get it.
Back up.
What is it?
Girl, the reason why we hate men now.
Oh, here we go. What happened, Britt?
I swear, I just make the worst decisions when it comes to men.
Mm-hmm. That's because they had that weekend love.
That's what it was.
Wait. What happened to Dwayne?
Girl, he don't want to work. I'm paying for everything.
Ooh. Woo-hoo.
What's so funny?
Exactly.
Oh, I know. I just seen this coming. That's all.
And tell me how, please.
Hey. Please do not get Terrell started.
Wait. Zip it. I need to hear this.
Somebody needs to hear
it. Somebody. So listen, every time we came to town, it was a weekend, right?
Yeah, and?
Okay, where relationships are not weekends. Mm. Relationships are more like, you know, like Tuesdays, Wednesdays, like the middle of the week.
I don't get it.
Okay, look, man, every time we came to town, it was on a Friday, right?
True.
Okay. Well, Friday, that's turn up time. So he partied all weekend. Mm. Then he left on Sunday. And then y'all do it all over again next month. Mm. See, that wasn't a relationship. Hmm. That was more like a fling.
Yeah. Okay.
You get it? See, now you're in a relationship.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So he don't get to see you when you sick, when you all coughing and all. You know, you need a little, you know, you got a headache. And when it's that time of the month, because, you know, we don't really
I think I got it. Wait. The slow days are the days that count. The Tuesdays, the Wednesdays, and the Thursdays, right?
Yeah, middle of the week.
Okay, I hear you.
Listen, it's easy to love a woman at their best. But love me at my worst. That's what really impresses me.
Preach.
But it's like everybody likes it when things are perfect. But when it goes wrong, they're not in for it.
Hey, look, welcome to a relationship. That's how everything goes.
I'm just really not feeling it. Like, he's turning me way, way off.
Well, first of all, any man with no job would turn any woman off.
I mean, it's not only that, though.
What is it?
His sex drive has decreased. Can y'all stop? This is not funny.
All right, listen. I could probably get vouch for him.
How?
Listen. When he came on the weekend, he was here for like, what, 2 or 3 days?
Yeah.
So he had to get in like 3 or 4 times real quick, you know what I'm saying? Because he's going to be leaving the next day, right?
True.
Okay, so now you're going to be there already. You're going to be there the next day. So ain't no rush. You know, he got in-house. You feel me?
Yeah.
You're going to be there.
I guess.
Wait, you know what? I talked to Terrell yesterday, and we kind of knew what was going on, so we decided to give him a call and give him a job.
Oh, thank you so much.
Hey,
look, don't hold me too hard. My sex drive is high.
Look, thank you, okay?
No problem.
Because he damn sure needed it.
Hey.
What?
Listen, Terrell, listen, I got a question, right? Can you just tell me a little bit more about this middle of the week theory you have on love?
I got you.
Yeah,
So on Tuesdays, right?
Uh-huh, Tuesdays what?
You first.
What? Okay. Uh-huh.
And Wednesdays.
This actually nothing happened. Like,
yo,
what the hell?
I just really want to appreciate you for the opportunity. Yo, this is like starting from 0 to 100. I could totally change my stratosphere as far as the professional atmosphere, yo. I'm talking about completely changing my life, B.
Hey. It's only $8. Before taxes, no benefits, no 401k. Well, I don't even think you qualify for 401k. And it's kind of a glitch in the system, so you still kind of get billed for having medical insurance. I don't know what it is. I'm going to fix that. Oh, and your first 3 checks, you pay for your uniform and your tools and everything else, okay?
Sticky.
And listen, I do not believe in the union. Union talk will get you fired immediately, all right? Man, I like you. I like you. Don't tell nobody about your pay.
No.
All right? Oh, Lord. You know what? I was actually looking for you, Skinny Cool. Let me come
holler
at
you. I was in the back working hard, boss.
Well, come here. I need to talk to you for a second.
You talk to me for a second?
Yes. I need to talk to you for a second.
Come on, man. You ain't going to find me on my birthday, is you?
It's your birthday?
Oh, yeah, man. Come on, man. You ain't going to find me, is you?
No, I actually
Whoa, boss. Before you start, I ain't take all them paper clips.
Paper clips?
I didn't.
Paper clips. You took paper clips?
What?
You took my paper clips. Did you take my paper clips?
I thought they was company paper clips.
No, they were my paper clips.
I don't even know what you're talking about, man.
You just said you took paper clips.
No.
Skinny Cool, were you mopping or doing plumbing? Where's the uniform that I brought you?
What, who is supposed to be my replacement? Who is this?
Well, actually, I see that you need a little bit more help on the second, third, and fourth, and fifth floor. So I got you some little help so you can kind of manage. Well, not manage, watch over. I'm sorry.
So what you're trying to say is that he under me.
Yeah, he'll be working alongside of you.
Side of me? No. So, I'm like his superior, or supervisor.
No, you're more like a lead to kind of show him because you've been
lead
here longer.
Lead supervisor. All right, boss, I got it.
You know what? Hey, how about y'all just get acquainted? I'll be right back, okay?
Okay, I got it. Right. I'll take it from here.
All right.
Look here, man. You know I already don't like you because you just told him a woman coming down here every weekend shining. But let's get something straight, okay? First things first. If I want to take a nap, just for a little while, a couple hours, what you gonna do? You gonna cover me. Understand? If I slip and fall, break my Achilles tendon, and claim unemployment for 6 months, even though it really didn't happen, you gonna cover me. Let's say it with me. Skinny Cool, I'm gonna cover you. All right, you starting to get a hang of this. And one more question I got to ask you. What's Jay paying you?
We're not supposed to discuss employee compensation against other employees.
So he gave you the value plan, huh? Now, you ain't got to answer me verbally, okay? Just nod or shake your head no if I get this right. Hold on. He started you off at $8 an hour, flat, before taxes. You ain't got no health benefits, no 401k. And your uniform, your first three checks is gone, man. Lord, I don't know how he keep getting away with this, man. It should be some kind of labor laws. He was just in court last week about this. But look here, man. I ain't talking about nothing. I ain't HR. But you might want to consider a union. Anyways, hold on one second. Do you hear that?
No.
You don't hear that?
Well, no.
Come closer. You got to listen to it. Come on. Chum. Yeah, man, it's a toilet on the fifth floor with your name on it. Let's go.
I'm gonna take the elevator.
No. You can't take the elevator, man. Only supervisors take the elevator. But since today is your first day, I'm gonna be nice to you. All right? Here you go. Go down this hallway, make a left. You're gonna see a rock in the door. Don't kick that rock out, that's why I take my knapsack. That's the stairways. Gonna get you some exercise, man. Boy, when Air Jordans on his first day of work. Lord have mercy.
My family was so not happy with how you acted this weekend. What was your problem?
What do you mean, what was my problem?
You didn't even play Monopoly with anybody.
I hate that game.
Probably because you're not smart enough to win.
Excuse me?
Nothing.
No, what did you just say?
Stop. Look, my issue with you is you barely said a word to anybody. Then you kept putting salt on everything.
The fool would try.
Really, Jay? Really? What about my dad? It was like you're trying to sabotage it. He must have asked you like 1,000 times to go fishing.
I don't like fishing. I'm from Carroll City. We don't fish.
Look. Oh, my gosh. I get that, Jay. Baby, that's why I'm here.
That's why you're here.
Jay, you need to be more cultured. I'm here to wipe Carroll City off of you.
So Jay. I should be thanking you.
Yeah, Jay, I'm here to broaden your horizons, baby.
So I still should be thanking you.
Absolutely. Trust me, this ain't easy when you have to start from scratch.
You know what? This is not working. This is, me and Joy Love is easy.
What, who? Who is Joy? Who is Joy, Jay? I'm Alicia. I know you ain't just called some other woman name in front of me.
You know what? I remember when we used to race shopping carts down the street, and the winner used to have to wash dishes. Or even when, on our anniversary, we didn't have enough to eat at Denny's, and it took all our money to buy a $1.99 Grand Slam. Like I said, not you, but Joy.
Again, you gonna talk about Joy?
It's just...
What's your problem, Jay?
It was just easy.
Easy?
Yeah.
Is that what you want, easy? Look here, Carroll City. I'm a catch. I'm perfect. Let Beyonce tell it I'm flawless, and you know it.
Well... I'm not impressed.
Jay, this is crazy. Look, just because we have hard times doesn't mean anything. Besides, what makes her love better than mine?
Her love was comfortable.
So comfortable and easy. That's what you want? Well, I'm not easy, and I'm damn sure not comfortable with being second. You're lost. You'll regret this.
Wait, hold on, Alicia. I was coming to get the door.
Get out of my way.
Hey. Look, I apologize you had to see that last night.
Yeah, you know, I thought I could handle seeing you with other women, but until I passed by Chef Creole and I seen you feeding confidence to other women, confidence? Oh, you don't even do that with me. I mean,
oh.
Look,
I can't.
I mean, it's cool. I respect the fact that you came like an adult. Let me know how you feel, you know?
Yeah.
Cause boy, I'm just glad you didn't slash my tires up, keep my car up, bust my windows out. Boy, I had a Tanya before? Oh my God. Tanya? She was blowing me up. I kept ignoring the texts, calls, all that there. I finally answered the phone one day. She like, Terrell!
Boy, you better pick up this phone, Terrell! Boy? Look downstairs. I look downstairs. Oh, boy, you want to slide on me? How you going to slide with no tires, huh? Huh?
I'm on bricks down there. It's like, oh.
Oh. I thought about it. But you kept it real with me since day one, and I had the choice to either take it or leave it. And I'm leaving it.
Mm. Ooh. You all right?
Yeah, I just almost stepped in some feelings right there. Careful.
What? Okay.
Terrell, why is she crying?
She crying.
Yeah, she's crying. Yeah, what do you do?
I should be the one who be crying. She just broke up with me, bro.
Ooh, she is so fine. You see all that tight stuff she had on, man?
Hey, you know I see
it. Hey, man, you know what? I always wonder what she will wear if she goes ever to meet your mama. Would she put on that same tight outfit?
Well, she would never be my old girl. You tripping. I was going to take her to meet Uncle June then. Uncle, that's what I was taking to see.
What? Are you serious?
Yeah. Come on, man. You don't want to get down like that. It's her fault anyway, man.
What do you mean it's her fault?
Look, man. The woman that makes it worth it to leave all the other girls alone, that's just the one I'm going to be with.
And she didn't do that?
Hey.
Oh, hey, Joy, I've been waiting on you. Hey.
The place looks great.
Yeah.
What did Terrell say?
I don't know. He was a little hesitant because he said it could get messy because he thought we would probably get back together.
That's what he's worried about?
Yeah.
That's never going to happen. He's so funny.
Yeah, but I told him you didn't look good anyway. So.
Look, we're just business partners, right? So it doesn't matter.
Yeah. Unless.
Unless what?
Unless we begin to.
Oh, this here ain't gonna work.
That way over there.
Terrell! What's up? It's been a minute.
Yeah, Joy.
Still the playboy out here?
Hey, you know I do what I do,
yeah,
baby.
Yeah, I know some things never gonna change.
You look good, Joy. You looking real good.
Thanks.
You look nice. You been working out, lifting weights, and doing squats. And I see you back there. You looking face all nice too. Face nice, beat by the gods, ain't it? Yes. No acne. Not at all. Come on. Hair look all good too. You got all your teeth, MCT, baby. Ooh. Oh, 32, huh?
It was the back teeth.
Yeah,
it was the back
teeth. Okay. Yeah, Jay, I see you, baby.
Difference a day I make, right?
So I hear Jay tells me that you want to partner up with us now.
Yeah, I'm just waiting for your approval.
Hey, it's all good with me. As long as you guys don't make this a romance.
Oh, I won't.
No. Huh?
We won't.
Okay, look. Just let me know when the paperwork's done. I'll be here with the money. I have so many great ideas for this place, guys.
Cool. Hey, Joy.
Yeah?
You got a dude anyway, right?
Do I?
Just go, man. Go. Bye. Just go. Yeah.
Where is everyone?
Well, that depends on who you're looking for.
A real man. You seen one?
See, I know you act so hard.
Why is that? Another man who thinks he knows me, huh?
I don't think I know you, but I definitely know your kind.
Oh, really, Mr. Terrell? Since you're so smart, enlighten me, honey. What's my kind?
Since school is in session, baby, I need you to have a seat. See, you take a long time in between relationships.
So?
But the dude still ends up breaking your heart anyway. And then you become bitter. You hate on your friends and your family. Why? Because they're all in great relationships. And you become that bag lady, you know, like Erykah Badu was talking about. Yeah. That's you. Yo, you're like a sniper.
Really? So yeah. How am I like a sniper?
Wow, I actually wrote a poem about women like you when I was in college.
Here you go, let me hear it.
Let me see if I remember this.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, here we go. So you're a good girl who always studies to pray. Mm-hmm. You never let them know what you're thinking. But when you love this hard, you become too smart. See, you stay on a boat, even though it's sinking. I mean, I would too if I took all this time out to pick out the perfect match. So if it doesn't work, you stay with the jerk. I mean, hell, who wants to start from scratch? Next time around, you take even longer to make sure he's just your type. Now you're back in love and he's all you're thinking of. And love is just like riding a bike. You let your guards down because you trust your decision. After the 10th screening, that is. Then you think he's your man, and here we go again. That bullshit begins. Now all this analyzing has no meaning, but another breakup, another heartbreak, and now you're back up against the wall. So you try to protect your heart, and that's smart. And so once again, hello? Love calls. 2 years go by, now you're back in the game. You're giving it all you got. See, you let most pass you by until that one catches your eye.
I get it.
You got to hit it. You only got one shot.
The sniper. Yeah. Bravo, bravo.
Hey.
I gotta hand it to you. That was actually pretty good.
See, I've been watching you. You look good, too. See, women like you, they always have their life together. Great job, nice house, own car, everything. But the fact still remains, you're still alone.
That was harsh.
No, it would be if I wasn't going to do anything about it.
Did you just kiss me?
I apologize.
Yeah, you need to apologize for stopping.
Oh my God. This is like the first time in a long time I actually feel really good.
You're used to it.
Take it slow. I'ma let you decide the tempo. But one thing's for sure, I'm hitting it tonight, yo. Girl, tell me if you feel me too. The way that I'm feeling you. Cause I can go deeper, deeper. Tell me.
Ooh, my Honda wouldn't cut off when I turned it off. Hey.
Hey.
Thanks for lunch, or going out with me to lunch.
No problem. Thanks for having me.
I know at lunch we just talked about business, but I actually want to catch up with you. So what you been up to?
Well, after we broke up, you know, I went to Texas for school.
I remember.
And then grad school, so now I'm back here home, so.
So why did you come back? Did you come back for a man?
Actually, yeah, I did.
See, that's what I like about you, Joy. You're not scared to take risks. You see a man that you want, you career-oriented, you go get it. You don't make, like, ooh, if more women had drive to step out the box. And
but, Jay, you know it's not you, right?
And why the hell would you come back, huh? What woman leaves her job, her career, and chases a man? You were smarter than that. You have an MBA. You just don't do things like that.
Why do you seem so shocked?
What,
you thought I'd just be sitting around doing nothing?
Not doing nothing, but at the same time.
Waiting for you. You expecting me to be waiting for you?
Not waiting, but just.
The funny thing is, you actually thought I should have been waiting for you.
Not waiting, but at the same time.
Not falling in love with anybody else, right?
Yeah.
And I can only imagine what you've been doing for the last 4 years.
Hey, hold on.
Yeah, I bet.
Let's not go there. Well, it doesn't matter. You jump. Who is this guy you're talking to anyway?
Look, I don't think you want to go there.
Maybe I do.
You sure?
Yeah. How about you give him a call? I would like to meet this guy.
Hold up. You want to meet him?
Yeah.
So let me get this straight. You want me to call my ex to talk to my ex-ex?
Yeah.
Call him. Okay, then I'll set it up.
Fine.
Whoa, what are you doing? You stealing kisses now? It's a little thirsty, Jay.
I gotta be thirsty because I tried to steal a kiss?
Just a little bit. Yo, what would you do if I just walked up to you out of all this time and I just kissed you?
No, Joy, I'll probably never let you go.
To love me, love me, hold me, hold me.
look so cute with your little bucket and plunger. You got a job. You're working.
Set this right here. Well, I did everything you asked me to do.
Thank you.
I got a job. Mm-hmm. You know what? Your face around this place, the recommendation, gotta love it. I get paid $8 an hour.
Woo! That's a lot of money.
Yeah, I got 300 seconds to call you, too.
Really?
Yeah, out of my 15-minute break,
mm-hmm.
5 minutes to get outside, 5 minutes to place the call,
uh-huh.
and then 5 minutes to get back in.
Mm-hmm.
No benefits.
No Obamacare.
No union. So if I get let go, that's it. I'm gone. There's no second chances.
Mm-hmm.
Sick days, there are none. My only option is to go to work or die. No insurance. Isn't this everything that you want me to do? Everything that you asked for.
Dwayne, a job shouldn't be something that only I want. Like, bruh, for real. You don't want to work? You don't want to get up and take a shower and put some clothes on and earn yourself some money?
Yo, I want to work, but I want to work the way I want to.
I don't get it. A job is a job.
To you?
Money is money.
To you?
Everybody needs a job to be happy.
Yo, to you. Everybody's different, man.
You can say that for, again, because I thought you were different. I thought you were a manly man.
I don't know how you thought that. All I did was come down here and party. So right now, I'm confused.
You know exactly what I mean. And all that smoking weed in my kitchen and messing up my apartment?
Yo, I told you I don't even smoke like that. What you go do? You go buy a whole damn OZ, take all my money as soon as I get off the plane.
What, you thought I was gonna pay for it? But what I did do is go to the Pork and Beans Projects for you, looking for marijuanas for you, screaming for a weed lady at 3 in the morning for you, and then she made me pay $80 for a whole ounce.
Yo, you serious?
Yes, $80 that I don't have right now for you.
I can't believe that, yo.
Yes.
You spend $80 on a whole OZ?
Yes.
Yo, I knew I've been smoking Reggie this whole time, son. That's why I wasn't hitting the back of my throat.
Really?
I told you not to even pay for it. I said get a Nick bag. Nah, maybe a dime bag. Yeah.
Okay, but you smoking all over the place, right?
I smoke in the garage. You got one that smoked on the deck. You got even madder. So what I do, I smoke and blow it out the window, and then you got hot. So, yo, let me ask you a question real quick.
What?
Where can I smoke?
I don't know because I don't smoke.
So why buy it if I ain't had nowhere to smoke it? And they ain't getting mad because I mixed up all the wash rags and the dish towels all over the place.
I buy them by set. You grab a blue washcloth, you grab a blue towel. What is so hard?
Oh, yeah? What about what happened at the mall?
Oh, that was total disrespect.
Yo, I asked you if the shirt looked good. You said nah. So I asked the lady. She said yeah. How is that being disrespectful?
You think it's okay to ask a woman what looks good on my man?
She was 60 and she worked there, yo.
Okay. What about your hygiene?
What about it?
Taking a bath?
Now you know I take showers in the morning.
No, I don't. After working here all day, you have the nerve to jump in my bed, smelling all funky?
Hence, that is why I take the shower in the morning.
Perfect. Clean on your way out, but stink on your way in, right? And we're in Miami, Florida. It's okay to take like 3 baths. We're not running out of any water anytime soon, I promise you.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well, what about you?
What about me?
Every time I go in the kitchen,
here we go.
You following behind me to make sure I ain't putting nothing out of place. Like a damn inspector. Hey, yo, inspector. I passed inspection today?
No, you did not pass inspection today. Because you left the cabinet door open and Lil Coco could have went up there and ate all the chocolate and died.
Yo, if Lil Coco.
Yes.
Would have crawled onto the counter,
mm-hmm.
up the cabinet, opened it, and then ate all the flaming hot sun, all the gushers, all the fruit by the foot, all the pecan spin wheels, all of the grandma cookies, all of the donut sticks, not to mention his own dog food to get to that chocolate, yo. We should be looking for a suicide note.
It would not be funny if my dog died.
But if he did, you cannot rule out suicide.
I swear.
Yo, you want me to pack my stuff and go home?
Now that's something we shouldn't rule out.
Yo, I swear to God, she's stressing me out, son. I don't need all this stress. I need me some weed, a nice joint. But I ain't got nowhere to smoke it. Motherfucker, yo.
Yo, you mean to tell me you got feelings for her again already?
Yeah, I do.
I mean, what you mean? Like, they coming back, y'all back together? What is it?
I don't know. We both got to talking, and we both realized that we still have feelings bottled up inside, and now they're starting to explode.
Yeah, I bet, man. Look, man, as long as y'all don't make this no drama, I'm cool with it.
Hey, listen. Terrell, it's not going to be no drama. Nope, it's not. To make sure that it won't be no drama, we both decide to tell each other what we've been doing for all the couple of years while we were apart.
Boy, you be pillow talking. Ooh. Oh, man. Come on, man. Only two people in this world would do that.
Who?
Someone on that deathbed and a dummy.
So, I'm assuming that I'm the dummy.
You damn sure ain't on your deathbed.
Funny thing is, I've been content to tell her about everything that we've been doing, and she started to cry. Then she told me about this guy she was messing with. But the funny thing is, I felt great because I realized that she's all that I ever wanted because she hasn't been messing with a bunch of dudes. She's wife material.
Okay, Jay. I don't know how to feel about that.
What do you mean you don't know how you feel about it? She only been with one dude and you don't know how you feel about that? Come on, Terrell. You're being a little harsh.
Jay, first of all, she could be lying.
Joy wouldn't lie to me.
Okay, even if she's not. Look, I prefer her to be with what? Two, three, maybe even four dudes. But come on, one dude in 4 years? Jay, that's kind of scary, man.
I was with her for the first 5 years before that.
Yeah, five play years. Eighth grade to high school. Come on, man, that's nothing. Look, man, he had four long, her growing into a woman. Oh, my God, you know how precious those years are? You know how much he taught her in the bedroom? She probably was talking back, tongue kissing real good, looking at him, throwing it back. Woo! Can you compete with that? You didn't know what you was doing in high school. You were shooting that dog water, boy.
Listen, you really know how to make a man feel good or like he's been done wrong by his woman.
Hey, man, I'm just saying. You got to weigh out all your options, Jay.
Well, you know, I called Paul the other day, and he's supposed to be coming down here.
Paul? Who is Paul?
Her ex-boyfriend.
Damn! So you know Buddy's name now?
I mean, I know his name because
that's your woe now?
No, that's not my woe.
So y'all be hanging out and all that, taking shots, just popping bottles, all that, just wilding out, huh? That's what y'all be doing.
No, we don't be doing that.
Running through the six with my woe. Ooh, Jay, I see you.
No, man.
I've been running through the six with my woe. You know how that go. You know how that can go.
Come on, man.
So, hey, look, man, look. Be careful what you wish for now, I'm telling you.
Hey, look. He was nothing but a rebound anyway.
All right, man. You better hope so. Hey, I'm out of here. I got to go help Leah with her homework.
Huh. Hey.
There she go. You know what, Joy? Last night was freaking amazing.
Yeah. It just felt like old times where we would talk and laugh all night long.
That smile. That's that smile I miss. You know what? I really thought that I was going to spend the rest of my life with you. You don't believe me?
No, I don't.
Really? Why?
Let's see. What, we date for 5 years? You were my first everything.
You was my first everything.
But I loved you to death.
But I still love you.
You know, I could have went to any school in America, but I stayed here. I went to community college just to be with you. And what do you tell me after 5 years, you don't think you're ready to be in a relationship?
You
really?
Don't understand how it feels to be a man, Joy.
Okay, I'm listening.
Well, maybe at 22, I felt like if I got into a relationship
that... You would be missing out on something, right?
Yeah. So I decided to let you go and experience life, so if I don't know, I just didn't want to hurt you. So I figured I'll let you go.
You know what? I got it, Jay. So, if you love someone, then you should set them free.
Yeah.
If they come back, then they're yours. If not, then it wasn't meant to be. Did I get it right?
Joy, that's what I was trying to
say. That was probably written by an insecure man just like you, Jay. You played with my heart.
I did not want to hurt
you. But you did.
But not in a cheating way.
Pain is pain, Jay.
You know what? We needed this. I needed this. Kind of get this all out in the open so we really know what we're getting ourselves into. Can you do me a favor? Can you call Paul and tell him not to come? I kind of got the direction where I want to go with.
You called him?
Yeah, I called him.
Why?
I don't know. I was confused. I just wanted to bring clarity. So can you call him and tell him not to come? I already know what we should do. And how? Please, hurry up. Did he pick up?
Hello?
It feels like a lifetime. A thousand days have passed by since I held you close to me. If I could see that smile, there's more for me than for you. Girl, I finally see there's no substitute for what we had.
You had something you wanted to talk to me about?
Yeah, actually I did.
I wasn't talking to you. But nice to meet you. You must be past some future. Girl, look at you. Come here, girl, looking good as you want to.
Wait, hold on, boy. Is this the type of guy you've been talking to while we was apart?
I mean, yes, this.
For the last 4 years, 8 months, 26 days, I mean, who's counting? Me? Us?
You do know I was Joy's first love. Whatever. No, her first lover. No. Her first everything.
You know, man, that's cute, man.
Cute.
Yeah, you still counting that kitty love?
Kitty love.
You know, that grade school stuff, like me and Joy sitting in the tree. K-I-S-S-I-N-G type love, that's cute, man.
Hold on, man. I never did that.
I mean, hold on to it.
Sophomore year. No? Okay. No,
hey, look. I respect that.
Hey, you don't got to touch me to talk to me.
You're right. I respect that. You know what I mean? I mean, someone had to get all that out the way, so when she met a real man, she knew I wasn't a little boy.
You know what? She needed this. We needed this. She needed to go out there and experience somebody else's love so she can know what to compare my love to.
You're right, but honestly, you should be thanking me.
Thanking you? For what?
I mean, think about it. After all that elementary loving you gave her, I had to teach her so much in the bedroom. I mean, poor little thing ain't even know how to tongue kiss, huh? But she learned, though. I taught a couple things with the tongue, you know what I mean? Hey, Joy, you remember our 3-year anniversary in Barbados?
But hold on, you went to Barbados?
Yeah. We all had that Maxwell playing in the background, and we really did it till the cops came knocking. What y'all doing in there? Yeah, we both loved that island. Too bad we only got a chance to see it from the resort windows.
Reminisce. Because that's all you're going to be doing from now on is reminiscing about the love you have for Joy.
You know what? See, I like how you standing so tall for your love all of a sudden.
Well, that's what I do.
See, I don't think you did that in the past.
What do you mean by that?
Well, you're in advertising and marketing, right?
Yeah, this is my spot.
Like what you got going on with the place. Well, I heard you never advertised your love for Joy until it was too late. I mean, planning a convention in New York on her birthday?
Well, see, what happened that weekend. See, what was actually, that was already... I was actually the...
I would have never did that. You see, Joy, when you're looking for me, you know how to find me. All you got to do is look in the mirror, see that beautiful woman you become, and I bet I cross your mind. Let me guess. I steal your spot? I like what you're doing with the place, Jit. Yeah. Got a little molding on the wall and stuff, but you can fix it up. Joy. Joy with me. Used to be you with me. Joy. Joy with me. You with me.
I gotta go.
Joy, wait. How am I supposed to compete with that?
You should never set me free.
One man's trash is another man's treasure, but you take me.
About last night. Oh my God, it was so amazing. Oh my God, I've never experienced something like that in my whole entire life. To see a man lay down on his side with his knees bent and his hands between his knees. It was like crazy. And did you know you put your thumb in your mouth when you sleep? No. Oh, it was, I don't even know how to explain it. It was like mind blowing. I tell you, you know what? And then, like, as the night went on, right? I couldn't sleep. So around 2 o'clock, I said, you know what? He's sleeping too peaceful. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna plant a kiss right on your cheek to see if you move. You didn't move! Oh my God! And then I was like, okay, I'm gonna kiss his forehead and then I'm gonna see if he's gonna move. Again! You didn't move! Oh my God! Like, I swear to you, it was the most beautiful thing ever! Then around 4 o'clock, like I said, I couldn't sleep. I swear to you, like, it was just so beautiful. Like, I had to take it all in. So around 4 o'clock, I started to get just a little bit cold. So I put my hand around your waist to see if he was gonna hug me back. You hugged me back! You really, oh my God. I was like, okay, well, is he dreaming? And if he's dreaming, is he dreaming about someone else? That's why he hugged me back. But then I was like, it doesn't really matter because you were there with me. Oh my God. It was the most precious night ever. I swear to God, like I got no sleep, but it didn't matter anyway. Like I'm so happy. Oh my God. Wait, I got a question. So, how was it for you?
Last night was straight.
I know! Oh, God, I swear to you. Okay, look, I got a really important question to ask you. Okay, I gotta catch my breath. So where do we go from here?
Well, slow down.
What? I mean, look, I listen, okay? I just gotta know.
It's only been a couple of nights.
I know, okay? All right. I just need to know, are we in it for the long haul? Or is this like a short distance,
thing? Hold on. Why can't you just let it play out?
Come on, Ralph, please. I don't want to get my hopes up.
And don't get them down either.
Can you just tell me yes or no?
Yes or no what?
Oh, God. I don't know, Terrell. I guess I think I'm just supposed to ask these questions after we make love for the first time.
Why? So you can always be let down?
Oh, you know what, Terrell? Whatever with your therapy.
Look, I'm taking the same chances as you are. I mean, hell, you may not even like me after a month. But you know what I'll do? I'll deal with it. I enjoy the memories. I say it didn't work out. And I move forward in the next relationship. Oh, man.
Look, Terrell, I really like you, okay? And if you're playing me, can you just let me know?
I'm not playing with you, Michelle. I like you.
Okay, I guess then if you stop liking me, can you let me know that too?
I will, you know that.
Okay. I feel better. Okay, so it's Monday. What are we doing tonight? Monday night football. I get to see Dan Marino make that three-pointer.
What? Dan Marino? It's 2015. Three-pointer? You know what? It's cool. Look.
What?
Tonight's just not cool for me. I mean, well, next Friday's cool, though. I'm wide open. I'm all yours.
Next Friday?
Yeah.
But today's
Friday.
Monday.
Mm-hmm.
So that's Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday?
Keep going.
Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday.
Hey, give me some. Woo-hoo. I got you. I'll see you next Friday.
Wow. Okay, I get it. Real time, right? Real time, huh?
Look here, man. You an overachiever, boy.
I like the way you work.
Listen, hey, next week, I'm gonna let you take a nap.
Skinny Cool.
What's up, boss?
Where's your uniform? Skinny Cool. Where's your uniform?
Oh, my uniform.
Yes, your uniform that you said was dirty.
Yeah, you know the cleanliness take about a week. It's in the cleanliness, man.
Can I ask you a couple of questions? Where were you the last couple of weeks? I haven't seen you in about a week.
Boss.
Were you at work?
Yes.
Were you at work?
Yeah, you ain't see me because I be here and there working.
Were you at work?
Yes.
What's Skinny Cool at work?
Started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now my whole crew.
Actually, Skinny Cool was working on a project on the third floor.
You wouldn't lie to me, would you?
Of course not.
Good. Hey, today I was actually about to work on y'all benefits, man. So y'all keep up the good way. And your PayPal didn't go through. I think my account was in negative, but I'll write you a cashier's check. Don't worry about it.
No new friends, no new friends, no new friends, no new do.
Yes, I can. I can work.
No.
No, I can't.
You look stressed, man. What's up? You all right?
Yeah. I met Joy's ex-boyfriend, Paul.
I told you not to do it.
Come to find out is... Terrell, she's still in love with him because she still want to reminisce about their love and keep communication.
You're not being fair to yourself, man.
What do you mean I'm not being fair to myself, Terrell? What do you know about love, huh? You have never been in love in your life.
Man, look, you know it's not realistic that a woman's history is going to be erased just because she met you, right? Her mind's not a computer, bro. Come on, Jay.
What do you mean? Mine is not a computer.
Man, look, you took the risk of letting her go and thinking she wouldn't find someone that was better than you. You thought when she come back, you guys just gonna run off in the sunset holding hands together? Nah, Jay, it don't work that way.
You're right.
So what now?
I don't know. I haven't talked to her in a couple of days.
Hey, man, that's what I was talking about, the same thing.
Right, look, man, I'll fix it, man. Well, I better fix it because if we don't, we're back to square one. We got to shut this business down.
See, that's exactly what I was afraid of, man.
Supposed to get a refill today. Supposed to get my hair done, but I missed my appointment because I had to come drop you off to work. And I would let you drive my car, but you don't got no license or no gas money. And I'll be damned if I put you on my insurance. But you're here. Just call me when you need me to pick you up.
Yo.
What?
Brittany,
I'm sorry, yo. I'm sorry about all the things I said.
Mm-hmm.
All I wanted to do is just come down here. I mean, I don't care about what I got on or what I got. I just wanted to love you.
Love don't pay the bills, okay? I really, really, really wish I could be as carefree as you, but at the end of the day, one of us has to take responsibility, and it's been me this whole entire time.
Well, maybe we let those weekend visits really get the best of us, and we always thought it was going to be like this.
It's true. And a good friend told me that love is not like the weekends. It's more like the middle of the week.
Tell me about it, yo. If I needed all this stress, yo, I could have went back and stayed with my baby moms, baby.
You really saying that right now?
Yo, for real? What did you want from me, yo?
I don't even know.
God, there we go. How you gonna look for something in a man and you don't even know what it is? You know what? You got all my permission to go ahead and do what most women do, blame the guy for everything, all right? I'll take the fall, but what I am going to do is I'm going to go back home, I'm going to regroup, call a few audibles, you know what I'm saying? Then I'm back down to Miami every month, and I'm going to be looking for a new Britney. Not this. I mean, look at you. You got a scarf on your head right now. This is how you come out in public? You fell off, son. I come down here, I wanna hang out, have fun, and I come to this. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go and get the new Britney. Britney with more money. Then I'm gonna come back down here and do what I do best. So.
You good. You good.
We loved hard. But who knew that this love was bad for our hearts? Threw down our defenses, lost all our sense, our bodies exposed. But moments of weakness slowly defeat us.
What a disappointment. Not only did this man drain my bank account, but he drained my hope and my faith in man. He showed no signs whatsoever. Of course he did. They all do. I'm so disappointed in myself. I get myself into this. It's not fair. It's not fair.
Brittany?
Oh, Skinny Cool.
Are you in here crying?
No. I got something in my eye. My
you
lashes.
In here crying. What's that boy's name, man?
What, Chomp?
Yeah. You in here crying over that Chomp.
No, yeah, he is one too. I tell you that for sure.
Yeah, he is, but you ain't even said it right. You gotta say it like bruh man from the fifth floor.
I'm not saying it like that.
Now, you gotta say Chomp. Come on, say it with me.
Chomp.
All right. That's what I'm talking about. You over there smiling, man.
What are you doing over here anyway, looking all cute?
Well, you know it's payday.
What about direct deposit?
Direct deposit with Jay? He's still trying to pay me with cashier's checks.
Oh, true.
I got to come get my money. Cash.
True, true, true. I do the same.
But it is what it is. Look at you. I'm glad I saw you smiling. Because you ain't smiled since that fool left here.
True.
You know that?
Mm-hmm.
But my job is done. I'll see you later. All right.
What do you mean your job here is done?
Since he got here, you was just down and out, dreary, moping around, not even yourself. But look at you. Just beautiful as you can be. But like I said, my job here is done. Your hair is flowing. I'll see you later. This is yours. All right?
But what if I want you to keep making me smile?
Come again.
I said, what if I want you to keep making me smile?
Well, let's see if this will work. You ready for this? I've been really trying, baby. Trying to get with you, Brittany, for so long. Now that you feel like I feel, baby, come on. Woo. Come on. We ain't gonna get it on, though. We can go have some ice cream or something, all right? Oh, wow.
Hey, where's Michelle? Oh, man. I wanted to take her to meet the old girl.
What's up? I've been calling, texting you, and I just seen you hang up on my call. Anyways, listen, I did some thinking and I'm ready. I can handle seeing you with other women.
Really?
Yeah. Look, I just want to have fun. I don't want to have my feelings in the mix. So we can get back to what we had. Whoa. You settling down now? Let me guess. Is it that chick Michelle that was asking all these sorts of questions about you? Oh, wow. So, how serious are y'all? Y'all getting married or something? Okay, well, congratulations on the wedding. I hope your girl knows you'll play it for life, and that's no bullshitting. Oh, come on, Terrell. He was talking about you. You know you're a player. We talked about this.
What did I tell you about that?
That you will keep being a player for life until one girl will make you stop messing with all the girls like me. Wow.
I guess you were right. Men are like track meets. And I think he's a long distance runner.
Wow. This is crazy. I can't find one guy that just wants to have fun. No feelings, no hassle, no relationship ties. I need a weekend lover. God.
Yo, what's your name?
Natasha.
Yo, I'm Dwayne. I think I'm exactly what you're looking for.
I think you are.
Hey.
You.
Hey.
What?
How you so okay with not having a girl?
Man. Look. I mean, I had girls I talked to, and you know, I just really ain't had nobody I gave a title to. But I had ones I cared about.
Like who?
Well, I'm actually talking to somebody right now.
Who? Michelle? Miss Negative? You know, I actually said a name that I know that you would never, ever, 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 ever talk to. Oh, we just talked about her so much, how much a bad attitude she was, and how sometimes she smells, and like you don't like the way her forehead is shaped. I mean, we were just doing all of this, Jonah, man.
Man, that was a long time ago. Jay, you tripping, man.
No, that was yesterday. You know what? I actually feel sorry for the person who impregnates her and has to deal with her for 18 years. I mean, look, man, she's bipolar. She's only happy when she got a man, and then when she don't have a man, she's all crazy. What? Something I said?
Don't worry about it, man. You just ruined all my little chances.
That actually made me feel kind of good. I needed that laugh. I actually did need that laugh. I don't know. Maybe sometimes you just need to laugh.
So what is it? Why do you want to keep me hidden from everyone?
Because
of what? Oh, you ashamed to be seen with me?
Of course not.
Okay, then what is it? We've been seeing each other for what, 6, 8 weeks now? And nobody knows how I feel about you.
I do.
Come on, Terrell, that's not funny, okay? I love you and I want the world to know I love you.
Why does it even matter?
Why does it matter? Why does it matter? Look, Terrell, you do something that no man has been ever able to do. You make me truly smile. You make my stomach hurt from laughing. And now you got my heart hurting from worrying. Like, all you have to do is just reassure me that you'll be here.
Michelle, look, I met this girl in college, and when I tell you we clicked, yo, we clicked. We laughed about everything. Right? We shared the same jokes. My Miami accent, she loved it. I'm talking about everything. Everything I did just worked for her. We never showed affection to each other in public for months. Until this one day on campus, she just started kissing me.
Really?
Yeah, like, I was benefiting from her, so I enjoyed it. I mean, it was odd, but you know.
I bet you was.
Come to find out, one of the guys got jealous.
Oh, wow.
And I found out it was her ex-boyfriend. So she was basically just using me to get back at him.
That was cold.
I guess it worked because they got back together. Left me out in the cold. That's what changed me.
Look, Terrell, I know you're about your business, okay? But you really need to know I'm here for you too.
Trust me, I know. I mean, talking to you all night on the phone, I'm tired the next day at work. Falling asleep in meetings. But it was all cool because I had a chance to think about you. I guess you were just distracting me from all things in everyday life. Now it seems like everyday life is just distracting me from you.
Sweat to you that loves.
Whoa. What's up?
What is going on here?
Nothing. Look,
I was actually just about to leave.
And step to the right.
Why your lipstick all smeared?
Yo, calm down. She's Terrell, just about to leave.
Terrell, are you excited to see me?
No.
Yes, you are.
Man, look, man. All right, look. We've been together for about 2 months now, all right?
What?
You what the hell?
Yeah.
Michelle, you told me you hated him.
Terrell, you talked about her all the time.
Yo, forget all that. Ain't no more jokes no more.
Ain't no
this
more.
My girl now.
Oh, that's your woe now.
Oh, huh? That's
yeah. So to make up for lost time, what we gonna do is, I'm gonna put some pictures on, you know, Facebook, Instagram, all that. You feel me?
Well, take a picture now.
I'll take a picture. This is Bae right here, Bae. We going on vacation, all that. We doing it,
taking your picture too.
Hold on. I guess everybody happy, huh?
Yeah. Really, really, you feel
kiss again. Kiss again.
Y'all is so cute.
I guess somebody didn't
change
things around here. Was it only me? Hey, ooh, baby. Ooh. Miss me?
Oh, let me have a seat.
It's for you. Hold up. Terrell. Don't tell me you were my girl now.
That's funny. That she's not your girl.
And I can tell you've been plotting this the whole time I was gone.
I ain't been plotting it. I mean, we just clicked after you left, so
well,
that's what it is.
You can go ahead and unbuckle your seatbelt, brother, because this ride is over. Rob is back, and so is my baby.
Shots fired!
Bop!
I'm actually glad you're back.
I know you are, baby.
I never stopped thinking about you.
I know you did.
What's your...
But for you, mister, you know you want nothing but the rebound, right? Nothing personal. Only business. Nah, but you get it.
Come yeah, on, Terrell. You were my rebound.
Hello.
Well, T.
Hey.
Remember that test you helped me study on?
Yeah.
I got an A.
Oh, that's a good job. Hey,
come on. You gotta go. I got that's the test outside right now. Right? You gotta go.
She called him Uncle R. Mm-hmm.
Baby.
See this? Wait. But Terrell, you turned into so much more.
Ooh. Hey, click it or tick it.
Bye.
Bye.
Whatever, chump.
Don't lean over too much, you might flip over.
Woo.
Woo. Where you going?
I got to go file these papers. This is enough drama for me.
No, you can take the day off.
Bye, boy.
Hey, Jay. So I actually wanted to talk to you about the other day. I know things got very heated and crazy between
actually,
you and Paul.
I did want to talk to you.
Hey, Joy, I need to talk to you for a minute.
Hold on, I was talking
Wait.
To...
Look, I got it.
So, did you think about it?
Yeah, I did. I thought long and hard about it, and I did what you said. I looked in the mirror at the woman I've become, and I didn't see you. I saw him.
I
sorry.
There.
What's this?
It's a letter. Just read it, all right?
Paul, I don't
know. Wait. At least you can do a read.
I thought it was official. He was out your life for good. He stopped coming by and saying hi. I thought it was understood. I knew it'd be tough for you. Y'all were together for 5 years. But he wasn't home those nights alone. I was there wiping all your tears. No matter what I do, because of time, he has a 5-year head start. As of today, I must find a way. I know he has your heart. Should I turn it up a notch and love you as hard as I can? I'm hungry and thirsting, but chasing the wrong person. He still has your heart in his hand. I'm officially throwing in the towel. TKO in the first round. In my soul, I knew my role, but still hard, man. Missed the rebound.
You know what? He wrote you this letter. I would have never did that.
Of Mr. Rebound, playing the part of Leah. Leah Adonat, playing the part of Skinny Cool, Jason Stanley. Playing the part of Alicia, Althea Jester. Playing the part of Robert, Mr. Kenny Daniels. Playing the part of Natasha, Miss Sheila Marie. Playing the part of Paul, Mr. Jarvis Wilson. Playing the part of Dwayne, Mr. Troy Brooks. Playing the part of Joy, Miss Jasmine Avery. And playing the part of Jay, Moses Mulwash Washington. Playing the part of Brittany, Bree Williams. And playing the part of Terrell, and Roe Rollins. And playing the part of Michelle, Miss Niji Samik. Ladies and gentlemen, he brought you Lily Haiti 1 and 2, Organic Love 1 and 2, A Woman's Worth Prenup, Where is the Love? Give it up for Mr. Damian McKnight.
All right, one more person. Benji Johnson, come out, man. That's my marketing guy. Right there. I'd like to thank everybody for coming out. I really appreciate y'all supporting the arts, and you know, other playwrights are having plays later on this year. So I want y'all to go out and support them too. Let's give it up for the cast. They did a great job tonight. You know, the family atmosphere that we create in this production, it shows. Every Sunday, we cooking. We found out we had a chef, Anro. We have a chef in here. We cook on a grill. We do everything together, and we all take breaks and eat together, and I really appreciate it. A lot of these actors have, you know, they're in school, some have kids, they have a lot of things going on, but they always, you know, made it back to rehearsal and everything, and they did a great job tonight. I want to give a shout out to Biggs. He back there in the back. He always supported from day one. I want to give a shout out to Damien, a real close friend of mine. And we definitely going to do some things in the future, man. There you go right there. And last but not least, to all my family members who are here, y'all always support me and don't think I don't appreciate it. I really do. You know, the McKnights, the Lawson, you know, Eric, Shalon, y'all like brothers to me, even though we're cousins. I really, really love y'all. And to my wife, you know, she's the one behind all this stuff. And yesterday, she got my back so much that yesterday was actually her birthday, and she was spent there organizing everything for the play. So. And I really, really want to tell you that I love you, and I really appreciate you, what you do for me. And let me stop before. another shout out to the makeup artist. She did a great job. And the set guy, Jay, where's Jay? He did a beautiful set. Let's give it up for Jay. And my right-hand man, Gene, he called the show, he's behind the scenes. He do everything. So thanks again for coming out, and I really appreciate it.